know you all have gotten a letter that I hand-delivered to the police commissioner this morning. And you know that this press conference called at this time is not about campaign signs. It's about something much more serious. It's about truth. It's about credibility. It's about the integrity of the voting process. Because as you know, the police department has a role to play when it comes to the voting process. In the letter that you received, I have proposed a solution to what I consider to be a serious credibility issue. This morning, I delivered this letter, and in the letter is a request that I made to the commissioner that we engage an independent investigator to get to the core of the truth. Now, if it was only about the signs, like I said, we would not be here. But this issue of truth, credibility, and veracity, this issue about the integrity of the voting process, these are issues that cannot be swept under the rug. They must be dealt with head on. The actions of the police commissioner do matter. They matter, and the citizens expect a police commissioner to be free of bias. They expect a police commissioner to be truthful. They expect a police commissioner to exhibit integrity. Now, over the course of the last couple years, as we have dealt with the issue under this commissioner of focusing our attention on getting violent repeat offenders off the streets, there has been, every single week, I believe, some action on the police part talking about how crime has been decreasing. That is a fact. It is borne out by the Uniform Crime Statistics, the UCR reports. Now, when this campaign began, however, we have seen actions which are out there saying, in essence, that crime is not decreasing and could be viewed as fanning the flames of fear in the community. Now, the issue of the signs would be, yes, it's inappropriate. But the issue of overt action on the part of the police commissioner to get into the office of the state's attorney, someone who is a rubber stamp for the police department, is very dangerous. And I'm here today to say it is a dangerous act. Overall, the majority of Baltimore City's police officers are hardworking, committed individuals who are out there putting their lives on the line every single day, keeping us safe. But there are police officers who do make mistakes, and yes, there are those officers who commit crimes. And you need an independent agency to assure that those who commit crimes are held accountable when it comes to the prosecution of those crimes. Anyone who has watched Law and Order knows that the police officers arrest, and it is the district attorneys, the state's attorney's obligation to prosecute crime. They're separate and independent. All I want is the truth. An independent fact finder will help us get to the truth. The three questions outlined in the letter that you have hopefully will get us to the truth, and after we have the truth, we can move forward and focus our attention to where it should be, and that is getting violent repeat offenders off the streets of our city, keeping them off the streets for as long as possible.